Hello and welcome to Communities at Work. This program is hosted by Community Prevention Partnership of Berks County, located at 227 North 5th Street here in Reading, Pennsylvania. Our phone number is 610-376-6988. Hola y bienvenidos al programa de Comunidades en Trabajo. Este programa es presentado por Community Prevention Partnership, localizado al 227 del norte de la 5, aquí en Reading, y el número telefónico es 610-376-6988. My name is Eliana Hoffecker, and I will be your host for this evening, along with my co-host, Gloria Santiago, who's to my left. To her left, I'd like to present some of our students for our program. Anthony Quiñones. Jeremiah Wolfram. Danny Velez and William Velez. Yeah. Mi nombre es Eliana Hoffecker y yo seré la presentadora en conjunto con mi copresentadora Gloria Santiago, que está a mi izquierda. Y al lado de ella están los estudiantes del programa, Anthony Quiñones. Jeremiah Wolfram, Danny Velez, and William Velez. Tonight's topic is Youth Against Pressure, one of our many programs at Community Prevention Partnership. El tema de esta noche es Jóvenes contra la Presión, uno de nuestros programas de Community Prevention Partnership. I want to start with a PowerPoint presentation just to go over the program and explain what the program is in a little bit of detail. Quiero comenzar con un PowerPoint, una presentación de PowerPoint para explicarles sobre el programa. El programa se llama Jóvenes contra la Presión. The name of the program is Youth Against Pressure, like I mentioned before, and it is a community prevention partnership program in partnership with Northeast Middle School and the Reading School District. Este programa es en conjunto con la escuela de Northeast Middle School y el distrito escolar de Reading. Youth Against Pressure serves families and their youth eight years and older who are at serious risk of arrest, addiction, and academic failure. Nuestro programa sirve a las familias y sus jóvenes de 8 años en adelante que están seriamente en riesgo de ser arrestados, caer en la adicción, fallando académicamente. One of the program's goals is to deliver 8 essential services to these youth and their families over the course of 2 years. In order to accomplish this goal, the program brings together the family, the school, law enforcement agencies, and social service agencies. Una de las metas del programa es llevar a cabo los 8 servicios esenciales para cuyos jóvenes y sus familias por un transcurso de 2 años. Para poder llegar a esta meta, el programa unifica a la familia, a la escuela, agencias de seguridad pública y agencias de servicios sociales. The 8 essential services are social support or intensive case management, family services, education services, after school and summer activities, mentoring, police involvement, juvenile justice intervention, behavioral incentives, and of course, fun activities. Los ocho servicios esenciales son apoyo social, manejo de casos intensivos, servicios familiares, servicios educativos, actividades después de la escuela y durante el verano, mentor, involucración de la policía, intervención de la justicia juvenil, incentivos de conducta y, por supuesto, actividades divertidas. The goals for our program is to improve attendance and grades, reduce number of violent incidents, provide more positive peer influences, and experience less negative peer pressure, strengthen attachments to school and teachers, improve parenting skills of parents and guardians, create positive connections with their children's school, for parents. receive needed services like help with housing and health care, increase standardized test scores for students in the schools, reduce discipline problems, help build a safer community, benefit from better integration of services provided by the school, law enforcement, and community organizations. Las metas para el programa es mejorar las notas y su asistencia a la escuela de los jóvenes. Tienen menos incidentes violentos, más influencias positivas con sus compañeros y experiencian menos presión negativa de grupos de pares. Tienen una conexión más sólida con los maestros y la escuela. Los padres mejoran sus destrezas de crianza. Los padres forman conexión con la escuela de sus hijos. La familia recibe los servicios que necesitan como ayuda de vivienda y cuidado de salud. Las escuelas aumentan las calificaciones de los exámenes estándares. Los problemas de disciplina reducen. La comunidad está más segura. Beneficios de mejor integración de servicios de la escuela, agencias de seguridad pública y agencias comunitarias. This is a family-oriented support network. Case managers work with the whole family, not just the youth. You cannot help a youth without understanding his or her family and community. This is our thinking. Case managers help families find jobs, health care, housing, address any issues that create barriers to the child's healthy development. Each case manager follows the youth and families for up to 2 years. This means Youth Against Pressure has the ability to guide youth through challenging developmental, school, and family transitions. Nuestro programa es una red de apoyo familiar. Las trabajadoras sociales de Jóvenes Contra la Presión trabajan con toda la familia, no solo con el joven o la joven. No se puede ayudar al estudiante sin entenderlo a él o ella, su familia y su comunidad. Necesitamos trabajar con toda la familia para poder ayudar al joven. La trabajadora social ayuda a la familia a encontrar trabajo, cuidado de salud, vivienda, enfocarse en situaciones que puedan crear barreras que impidan el desarrollo saludable del estudiante. Las trabajadoras sociales también continúan con el estudiante y su familia por alrededor de 2 años. Esto quiere decir que Jóvenes Contra la Presión tiene la habilidad de guiar a los jóvenes a través de los retos desarrollados en la escuela y la transición familiar. For more information, I have put up some contact information here. My name, Eliana Hoffecker, I'm the program manager. My email, which is eserrano@communitypreventionpartnership.org. Also, Gloria's information, she is also another case manager, and hers is gsantiago@communitypreventionpartnership.org. Also, our address and phone number, which I mentioned in the beginning. Para más información, aquí les tengo información de Gloria y de mí. Nosotras dos somos trabajadoras sociales del programa. El email mío es eserrano@communitypreventionpartnership.org. Y el de Gloria es gsantiago@communitypreventionpartnership.org. Y también tengo aquí la dirección de la agencia, el número telefónico que les di al principio, que es el 610-376-6988. Gracias. Bueno, ahora también les quiero dar más información sobre el programa, más detalles, no solamente del programa, de cómo es el programa que nos han dado, sino también más detalles sobre el programa que nosotros en donde nosotros trabajamos. Nosotros ahorita mismo tenemos 20 estudiantes en el programa.
Actualmente tenemos 20 estudiantes, sí.
I'd like to give you more information about our program. I'm actually going to do it in English, and Gloria's going to do it in Spanish. More details about the program that we do, not just the overall that the PowerPoint presentation gave you. Right now we have about 20 students enrolled in our program. We do about 132 contacts a month with families, and an average of about 15 referrals per month to other agencies.
Mensualmente hacemos un promedio de 132 contactos con la familia y hacemos 15 referidos aproximadamente por mes.
During the school year, we also have an after-school program that we do, and that's once a week. And some of the topics that we discuss in the after-school program are bullying, nutrition, conflict resolution, peer pressure, healthy relationships and communication, alcohol awareness, STDs, myths and facts, cyberbullying and sexual harassment, which was actually done by Iñabel Ruiz from the Centro Hispano and Women in Crisis. We also had another guest speaker, Tech Sergeant Brandon Stout from the National Guard, and he did one for us on trust.
Durante el año escolar, además tenemos un programa después de la escuela. Es una vez a la semana y presentamos diferentes temas como, por ejemplo, la intimidación, la nutrición, resolución de conflictos, presión de grupo, relaciones saludables y comunicación, alcohol, verdades acerca de las enfermedades de transmisión sexual. También tuvimos un tema por Inabel Ruiz del Centro Hispano, que trató sobre la intimidación a través del internet. También tuvimos un tema con Brandon Stout acerca de cómo confiar en los demás.
Él es de la Guardia Nacional. In May, we also had a family night at Northeast Middle School. We had refreshments, giveaways, we had raffle items, also resource materials for the families. We had two speakers that they each gave two presentations. One presentation was only for the students, and the other presentation was only for the parents. And the topics were cyberbullying, cyber safety, and sexual harassment. And that was also given by the Centro Hispano and First Women in Crisis. And the other topic was drugs and alcohol, and that was given by the Council on Chemical Abuse.
Además, en mayo tuvimos un programa para toda la familia y fue presentado en la escuela Northeast Middle School. Tuvimos refrigerios, tuvimos regalos, rifas y material informativo para los padres llevar a las casas. Tuvimos dos invitados que hicieron dos presentaciones cada uno, una para los padres y otra para los estudiantes. Y los tópicos fueron seguridad e intimidación en los medios de comunicación y acoso sexual. Y el otro fue sobre drogas y alcohol.
We received a lot of positive feedback from the families on the topics discussed and on the program in general. They really enjoyed having all the information and also all the resource materials that we had there provided. Also, the school had plenty of resource materials for them as well. The participants had really good questions. They were had a lot of good discussion points. Overall, everyone enjoyed the night, and everyone walked away with some good information, a prize, and some giveaway items.
Durante el programa recibimos muchas opiniones positivas de parte de la familia que asistieron en cuanto a los temas discutidos y en cuanto a nuestro programa también. Los participantes tuvieron muchas preguntas y algunos puntos de discusión de mucho interés. En general, al final de la noche, todos se fueron a la casa con muy buena información y premios y regalos.
And during the summer, we also have summer programs like we had said in the presentation. We actually did not host a summer camp this year, but we did have the kids involved in the 21st century summer camp. And actually, we also have weekly trips to the movie theater, the weekly trips to the movies after the summer camp was finished.
Durante este verano no tuvimos un campamento de verano de programa, pero nuestros estudiantes estuvieron envueltos con el programa de 21st Century. Y además, hicimos viajes al cine, hoy mismo fuimos, ¿verdad? Y han hecho otras actividades que se han divertido mucho.
Okay, we're going to take a quick break. right now, and I will be back and actually want to ask our students some questions and have them give some feedback.
You're watching Communities at Work on bctv.org. Be informed, be involved, be a member. For membership information, go to www.bctv.org/support/membership. For more information about your community and how to become involved, go to www.bctv.org.
Hi, welcome back. Like I said before the break, we are now going to actually ask some of the students some questions and have them give us some feedback on what they felt about the program.
Vamos ahora a hacer algunas preguntas a los estudiantes a ver cómo ellos se sienten acerca de nuestro programa.
Okay. So, how did you guys get involved in the program? Whoever wants to speak up, go ahead. Go ahead.
We were playing around the streets, acting up, doing bad things, and like a couple of days later I heard about the program in the school, but I was thinking it would be whack and everything.
But
then like
out.
But like Gloria came and she spoke to our parents and they signed us up. We were kissing, we didn't want to go, but when we went it was fun. It helped us stay out the streets, like it helped us out be good instead of getting us in trouble. We were in the program doing good, and my aunt didn't need to worry about anything that, oh, what are they doing in the street? They're going to break something, the cops going to come to the house, anything bad's going to happen. And she said, I like you guys to be in stuff like this, so you guys stay out of trouble, and now we know what she means about it.
That's great. That's wonderful. Anybody else? How did you guys hear about the program, or how did you get involved?
It was the same thing he said.
Yes, it was pretty much the same. That's very good. That's a very good synopsis. That's pretty much how it goes. Usually we get the referrals from, we actually do get the referrals from the school, from the guidance counselor, usually, or it can come from the teachers. And it's usually kids who are kind of acting up or getting into some trouble at school or at home or perhaps not going to school, having a lot of truancy issues. And we usually get the referral, and then we go and visit the family. We actually do two different intakes. We do an intake for the family or the parent, and we also do an intake for just the student separately, because we like to get both sides of what's going on. So we like to be thorough. Okay, very good answer. how has this program helped you? Like, how do you think the program has helped you?
Somebody else.
Anthony? How has the program helped you?
I think the program helped us by staying out of trouble, doing activities that we would have fun instead of being in the streets, like I said, you know?
Yeah.
And then being with someone that knows that they care and they're going to help us.
Good, yes. We do try to come up with activities that we think that the kids will enjoy, that the youth will enjoy. I don't want to say kids. They're not really kids yet anymore. We try to come up with activities that they enjoy. We actually get their input on certain things, on topics that we covered in the after-school program. We ask their opinion on what they wanted to talk about. So that was good. Thank you. What kind of activities did we do in the after-school program, or what was your favorite of the activities we did?
Trust.
Okay. The trust one was with Tech Sergeant Stout from the National Guard. That was pretty much fun because it was a hands-on, kind of physical activity. Do you guys want to explain like what you did? Do you remember?
We had a trust, like we had to make steps out of the wood, and we had to trust that they will hold the steps so that we don't fall or nothing.
That's right. And so go ahead.
And then we had to go on the wooden board and fall back. So we had to trust them to catch us as well.
Okay.
I forgot the other one. What was the other one?
Well, the step ones, you guys made a human ladder, basically, right? It was It was like each student.
Mm-hmm. Hold the wood.
Yeah.
Hold the stick.
Yeah, on top of their shoulders.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. And then they fell back, and they had to trust that somebody was going to catch them, that the other students would catch them. Was that kind of scary?
No.
No?
It was fun.
It was fun, but you never know.
I wasn't scared. I wasn't scared.
Did you think you would fall when you were falling back? Yeah. Yeah, I would have thought I would have fell. What else did you guys do during that one, the trust one?
We had a balloon going around the table.
Go ahead,
William. Like, we put the balloon in our stomach, and we got lined up, and you got to, like, walk around the table, and it tell you when to stop. He counts how many seconds are there.
What happened with the balloon?
We had to
if it falls, we start all over.
We had to make it go in their stomachs, and we had to make, like, a line.
That's right.
We have to make sure it doesn't fall on the floor, so maybe we had to do teamwork.
That was, yes, exactly, mm-hmm. Anthony. That's what I was going to say. That one was basically about teamwork, right? You had to hold a balloon between you and another person, and you guys had to walk in a line. And if the balloon fell, then you had to start all over again, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Which one else did you guys do that day? Was that the only two?
That was the only one.
Okay. Yeah, I like that one, too. That was one of my favorite ones. Let's see. What have you liked most about the program overall? Not just the after-school program, but the whole program overall. Of all the activities we've done, or
we get to see our friends.
Yeah.
We
still were friends, having fun at least. You know, being around.
And talk about the stuff we do.
That we do and everything, and we still have fun by doing games and everything.
Okay. Good. So you guys get to have social interaction with one another, right? And you guys get to see each other. Mm-hmm. That's cool. What have you guys been doing? Has your relationship with your families and the school improved? Would you say that it's gotten better?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, your parents let you do a little more stuff if you behave?
Yeah, have freedom outside more.
Yeah, more responsibilities.
Yeah.
Because we're going to sit it out next year.
Yeah, so. They say we're growing up to be teenagers, and, you know, we need to start doing our stuff on our own.
That's right.
Yeah, we're not kids anymore. Yeah. You need to start learn how to be a man.
Instead of being a kid.
Yeah.
Yes.
To let all the kids' stuff go and be older. So, like, I could say I had trouble in school with...
lots of students.
Yeah, lots of students and everything. And I was, like, not doing my work all the time. But now that, like, I turned 14 and I started thinking, like, now there's a new school year coming, I'm going to do good on my grades.
Great. Yes, you're right. Our students are usually 8th graders, 7th and 8th graders, and like the boys have said, they are actually going to be going into the Citadel next year, so it's going to be a big change for them, and it is going to be more responsibility.
Yeah.
I believe our time is almost up. So I wanted to thank everyone for joining us this evening, and I wanted to thank our students for coming and being part of this. I know it's a little nerve-wracking, but they did a great job, and I'm very proud of them. We're very proud of our students. And thank you for joining us this evening. We'll see you next month with the next Communities at Work. Have a great week, and good night. Gracias por estar con nosotros esta noche. Y quería darle las gracias a los muchachos por estar con nosotros y hablar sobre el programa y lo que ellos les gustaron. Y también nosotros estamos muy orgullosos de ellos. Y también gracias a ustedes por estar con nosotros esta noche. Y los vemos el próximo mes en Comunidades en Trabajo. Les deseamos una buena semana. Buenas noches.